In this tutorial, you'll learn how you can influence splines by soft selecting their vertices and assigning various effects to that selection. This can have interesting effects, especially if you're going for a cartoonish look in your animation. The technique is twofold and needs an influence helper in the scene to soft select vertices on one or more splines. You then need the spline influence modifier on these splines to pass that vertex selection up the stack so you can manipulate them. Both of these features are new and added to 3ds Max 2018.2 update. To experiment with this, open the scene named influence-start.max, use the download link found in the description section of this movie. It shows a terrain that has been modeled into a small canyon. The scene is already set up with ink and paint materials for a tune effect. The terrain started as a simple plane object, then a displace modifier with a gradient ramp was used to create the canyon depression. Additional adjusts were made at the poly level using freeform tools such as push-pull, shift and relax-soften. Ultimately, a turbo smooth modifier was added for further detail. You will create rails and rail ties to cross the canyon. You will do so using splines, so you can deform them into the cartoon effect shown earlier. Use Alt-W to minimize the perspective view so you can access the top view. Draw a line from the left to the right side of the canyon. Use the Y construction plane as reference. Construction planes display a heavier black line. To draw a straight line, hold the Shift key. Once the line is drawn, you can go back to the perspective view once again. Obviously, at this stage, the line has only two vertices. You need to add to that in order to deform the spline properly. You can certainly divide the existing line segment, but then you would need to know how many subdivisions you need ahead of time. Instead, it is better to use the normalized spline modifier in case you need to change those subdivisions. This way, you can decide and edit those numbers to your liking. Here, a segment length of 7 or 8 should be adequate, giving you about 40 knots. Alternatively, you can specify 40 as a knot count if that's what you're aiming for. Before moving on and shaping the line into a rail, you will need the spline influence helper to soft select these spline knots. You'll find the influence helper in the helper panel, and it is created in the viewport somewhat like a double sphere. It shows two spherical gizmos, one red, one orange, that represent the soft selection falloff you are about to define. Position the helper so that it overlaps the line. You will adjust its parameters in a moment. Select the line again, and apply a spline influence modifier to the top of the stack. And then use the pick tool to select the helper in the scene. Note how vertices get various color assignments, like when soft selection is enabled in the sub-object selection mode. The advantage here, however, is that you can relocate, or better yet, animate the helper to dynamically change the selection. You can, then, affect this dynamic soft selection any way you see fit. In this case, you only need to move that selection up in the Z direction. This can be achieved by selecting the line once again and applying an X-form modifier to it. The X-form modifier would transform the sub-selection only, and you can simply move its gizmo up by an amount that you like. At any given time, you can adjust the influence helper falloff parameters, or even the spline's number of knots, until you get an effect you like. Ultimately, to make the spline look like a rail, you can simply add a sweep modifier at the top of the stack and use a wide flange profile. There are predefined ink and paint materials in the scene. Use the dark one on the rail. To make the second rail, simply copy this one about 35 units along the y-axis. Make sure you use the copy option as you want them animated separately. Move the influence helper around to see the effect. To create the rail ties, you use a similar technique. In the top view, draw a rectangle shape. Make it fit between the two rails with an adequate width value. I'll use 10 units in my case. You want the rail to stay rigid, so you won't need to normalize the shape in this case. 4 vertices will do just fine. However, rectangle shapes have Bezier vertices by default, which do not help here. Right-click and convert the rectangle into an editable spline. Select all 4 vertices and turn them into corner type using the quad menu. Before you proceed, it is very important that no vertices are selected before you move up the stack, so click anywhere in the viewport to cancel the selection. Exit sub-object mode when done. At this stage, all you need is to add a spline influence helper and an X-form modifier as you did earlier. The easiest way is to select one of the rails and drag these modifiers onto the new rectangle shape. Drag the influence helper around to see the end results. Finally, give the shape a geometric form by adding either an extrude or a shell modifier. Assign a material for good measure. Relocate and copy the rail tie to complete the bridge. Move the influence helper around to see the effect it has on the bridge. The helper can be animated on its own, or can be hierarchically linked to an animated object, such as the car seen in the sample animation. To test that, merge the animated car from the finalized scene named influence-final.max. Scrub the animation. The car is seen crossing the bridge. It has simple position keyframes and bend modifier keyframes. Position the gizmo so that it is just behind the car, and then use the link tool to bind the helper to the car. Bingo! That was easy. Render your animation or simply view the sample file that was provided to you. You can also open the finalized scene and analyze it.